Okay, salam alaikum since UTM now is asked us to start with the online teaching, so I'm just practicing myself. So this is my first time using the apps, which is mainly as the screencast. So I hope everything's clear, but I will upgrade. I will improve myself from time to time. Okay, so today we start with our new chapter, which is chapter 4. So firstly, I'm sorry about the title of the here because supposed to be that one's supposed to be chapter 4, yeah. Okay, so we have a partial derivatives. So actually this one is the continuation of multivariable function that you have learned last semester. Okay, so we have learned how to sketch the graph, we have learned how to define the domain and range. So now we want to know how can we differentiate those particular functions where if we have more than two variables. So for example, we have our z is given by x squared plus y squared. So now then how can you differentiate that? So because we need to differentiate partially part by part, so it is named as a partial derivatives. And the rest here, these are all the application that we need to use the partial derivatives. Okay, so I'm not going to explain this bit by bit, okay, every single term, so you can do your own. Okay, so this is application. You just move to the notation. Okay, how can you have or write down the partial derivatives, right? Okay, so previously when you are given a function, a common function, and you have let's say y equal to x squared, yeah, so then when you differentiate that, we have dy over dx, because we know that we just need to differentiate with respect to x only, because there is only single variable type x and it is given by 2x. But now since we have more than two variable, one variable, for example you have z is x squared plus y squared, then you, since you have x and you have y at the same time, then you want to differentiate and you cannot just say okay I want to differentiate respect to x, and you cannot see you cannot just have to integrate differentiate respect to y because you have both of them. So then it depends on your what you want. Okay, let's say you want to say I want the function to be differentiated by respect to x, so you have to put del z over del x, so the del and the d just to differentiate, to make a difference between the normal derivatives and the partial derivatives. Okay, sorry, so just now I'll give you example x squared plus y squared. So you want to differentiate with respect to x, so del z, del x, or you can put in more simply z x, which means that we have a small thing there. And how about you want to differentiate respect to y? So del z over del y. So you have z y, right? We also can differentiate for more than one order. So if you want to differentiate again with respect to x, so you have del x of the del z over del x, right? You want to differentiate again with respect to x, then we have that process, or you can have del squared z over l right. All you have, you can, because the previous one you have zx, so now zx, and then you differentiate again with respect to x. And you can also have the mixed partial derivatives, where if your first derivative is with respect to x, then you want to differentiate with respect to y. So you have zx is the first one, and then after that y. So we call that as a mixed partial derivatives. So back to the notes. And we also can put the value AB at the point AB. So after you differentiate, then you substitute the value, and your final answer is a number. Okay. So there is something that you have to take note. We don't use the delta, okay? We just use the current thing, so delta. Right? And so now we look at an example here. So we are given a function where the function is in terms of x and y. So firstly, we are going to differentiate the function with respect to x, and after that, we have to differentiate the function with respect to y, and then the third one, using this one is, we know that this one is f y, and this one is f x. So the third one asking for f y. So by using the result of the second one, and we plug in the value of x and the y, and we get the number. Okay, so just the example here. Okay, so the function is x cubed 1 plus x squared y squared plus 4x. Okay, then the first question, f x, which means differentiate f with respect to x. Okay, look at here. How many terms that we have there? Three, right? First, second, and the third. Okay, we look at one by one. So look at the first term. So you want to differentiate the x cubed y with respect to x, which means that x is should be the variable, but y we assume that one is a constant. Okay. So when you want to differentiate something and there is a constant, let's say I put a number this of y, I replace the x cubed y. Now I change to x cubed 2. So when you want to differentiate with respect to x, what's happening? So you have 3x squared and then 2, just there, right? Okay, and then we simplify. But then because now you have 1, so now back to the original, so you have 3x squared and then 1. So that is the answer. So y does not change. So now we have 3x squared 1. Okay, and then look at the second one. Again, we have x squared, y squared. You want to differentiate only with respect to x, y, constant. So we don't disturb the y squared, this y squared, and just change to 2x and then y squared. So we have 2x, y squared. Okay, and then look at the third one for x, when you differentiate with respect to x, y. Okay.